Hello everyone and welcome to Motion Hub. Today we will see how to make this 3D coin in After Effects without using plugins. So let's get started. I will make new composition, new composition, hit OK, hit enter and call this one coin. Now click on the ellipse tool and make a circle. I will align it to center and I will change the color to something like this. Again, let's make another circle. I will change the color to something like this and make it center, scale it up a little bit. Now I will click on the typing tools and I will add a dollar sign, make it bigger. And let's change the color. Okay, and again align it to center. Now let's add the reflection. Click here in the rectangle tool and make a rectangle. Set it to gray. Click on the toggle switch mode to reveal the mode and set it to screen. And hit T in the keyboard and set it to 30%. I will hit R to rotate it. Okay, so we need to mask this area and I will add an effect. Right click, effect, channel, set mate, and choose from the text mat from layer and choose tape layer 1. And now we have this part cropped. So let's animate this one. I will hit B and activate the stopwatch. Move it here and then go to 2 seconds, for example, and move it something like this. And now we have this reflection. Let's rotate it like this. Okay, fine. Let's make it loop. So I will hit B in the keyboard and with Alt key pressed, click on the stopwatch and click on this little arrow and choose property and loop out type cycle, this one. Now, if we run preview this one, we will get it looping. Okay. Now let's make the 3D effect and I will drag this coin, make new composition, and actually we will duplicate this composition in the Z space. To do that you need to make it 3D and hit F4 to reveal this one, click on 3D and hit P on the keyboard to reveal the position. Now right click and click on separate dimensions and in the Z position with Alt key pressed, click on the stopwatch and I will write index -1. So what this expression does, it's move the duplicated layer to -1 pixel in the position. So if we hit Ctrl D, we will get 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so let's make a lot of copies and then I will change the active camera to custom view to see the 3D edge or 3D effect. We can't see it right now, so we need to change the color of the edge. And so to do that, select the second layer and right click, effect, generate fill. And we will add another color, so like this for example, and select this fill effect, Ctrl C, select all the layer except the last one and Ctrl V. Now we have this edge. If you want to make it thicker, just select the second one and Ctrl D again and you will get it thicker. Okay. Now let's get back to the active camera and then I will create a new, right click new null object, select all the layers and parent them to the null. Now let's make the null object 3D, hit R, and let's animate the X rotation. Okay, I will click on the stopwatch and go something like here, and let's rotate it. Okay, so this is what you have. Maybe it's better to change it to quarter for a faster preview. And this is what we have right now. So let's add the logo in the back. And to do that, hit enter in the coin tool and let's rename it to coin animation. And now let's do the logo. I will select the coin and Control D and hit enter and name it to logo. I will open the logo and I will delete this sign. Now I will import my logo and then I will drag it here, hit S, scale it down and put it in the center. Maybe I will change the color, effect generate fill, and put it under the our rectangle, our reflection. Let's call it reflection, hit enter and rename it to reflection. Okay, so now how to put it in the coin animation. You select the last one, last composition, and select the logo, and with Alt key pressed just drag it from here and replace the coin. It will change to logo. Okay, so now if you move, you will see we have the dollar sign here and the logo here. We need to correct the logo because it's flipped. Select the logo and hit S, and then click on constrain proportions and select the second one and set it to -100. Now let's animate it. Hit P to reveal the position, and then I will activate this one. I will put it here. Okay, now go to something like 2 seconds, hit the stopwatch and go to the beginning, and I will move it here, and now we have this one. Maybe let's change it to easy ease and this is what you have. Just to make it faster, I will move the position to something like this. Now I will hit U to reveal all the keyframes. Again, set the keyframes to easy ease. Okay, I will add another rotation after the 2 seconds. So when it comes here, I will activate the Y position, the stopwatch. I will go to 3 seconds and let's add right 2 here and it will make 2 times. Okay, and then again, select the keyframes and hit F9 to make it easy ease. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and if you have any question or any comments, please let me know in the comments below, and see you soon.